How does it feel to make an exit?
Well, it feels really great. You can achieve some of your small dreams. I decided to buy an American muscle car, a Ford Mustang, you know, that real American car, young and so on. So okay. I was like, I have the money, I'm young, I don't need to care about anything else, so let's go for it.
Nice to see you. After that, we acquire your nice app, which is very nice. It's even nicer when we hold it and do some things, some tricks. But the scope of this conversation is the for you to share your feelings, your thoughts about the whole process and about all the things that we've been together since the weird email that you've got from us and maybe thought that we are not so legit. You will tell until the moment that we became partners and we made this acquisition and exit, okay?
Yes, sure.
Great. So if you can tell me a little bit about yourself, where are you from, what do you do?
Yeah, so basically I'm from Italy, but I live in Czech Republic because of war, and I'm a US developer, so I'm like coding in Swift. And I'm developing application like across all the Apple platforms. Mm-hmm. So that's like my main job. I have like a full-time job. And then like in my spare time, I'm developing application for myself that I'm then developing and that I'm then just releasing on App Store.
So is it like a really 100% side job for what? For is it hobby or it's for money, you know, for making money?
Well, usually it's for hobby because I like to fill some gap in the market. I'm usually like creating some applications that are yes available because, as you know, are already existing 1 million of applications that are doing the same thing. But what I'm trying to do usually is to fill some gaps in the meaning that some application might not offer all the features and you need to download multiple applications. So what I'm doing is basically to group all the features into one and only one application and then releasing it and doing some just basic advertisement, because as you may know, like developers are not so good in marketing, they are just good in coding.
So can you please describe the app, what it's all about, what it is doing?
Yeah, so the app that you bought, so that I sold you, it's called Social Widgets, and it was the first application on App Store when iOS 14 has been released, and was basically allowing people to add their own social networks straight into your home screen or lock screen through widget. Take your phone, swipe, and immediately see how many followers you have on Instagram or subscribers on YouTube or whatever.
Yeah, in fact, I see that I'm using your app. I have, I don't know if it's a lot, it's not a lot, 300 followers, it's not so much, but yes, I'm seeing it every day. You found this gap in the market, right? And you release it and it made money. How much money or profit it made before we purchased it, remember?
So I think it was generating around between 800 and 1,000 euro per month.
Okay.
Because you bought it like after 3 months, I think that I was online, because iOS 14 has been released in September 2020. The app has been released in the end of October. So already in the end of November was having some 50,000 users. Then in December, 100,000. And you bought it like in January. We started to do some deals in January. So just 3 months, it just exploded.
Why did you sell it? So you have some nice app generating like a side job income. Also as a hobby, which is bonus.
In January that we weren't growing anymore like by 50,000 users like per month. And that I'm not so skilled in marketing, so I didn't know what to do more in order to grow the app. And with such a big amount of users, the earnings were quite low. So I didn't really know how to, you know, move on. And this, I had like other application developed and released around seven, but this one was the one that just grown so fast in such short time.
What have you done after the exit money?
Well, I will say to you that before to the exit, yeah, I tried to in somehow market the app. So yeah, I have been contacted by a company that was saying like, hey, we can help you to grow your application, okay, and we will split some earnings. And they said like, okay, well, we can try that. And they said, we will increase the downloads, we will do this, yeah, we will, yeah, do that. In the end, we signed a contract, and in the end, they haven't done anything, like literally zero.
We got to know you by sending you like cold emails, right? We identify your app and we send you like a personal email, but then please be 100% honest. What did you feel when you got this message from us?
Well, the thing is that I received a random email in my inbox, okay, with a Gmail account, and that was already, all right, okay, Gmail account.
Yeah.
And of course, the email was having like your name and surname at gmail.com, and I was like, okay, let's investigate a little bit more. And in this email, it was written, hi, we saw your application, it's like growing. It was some of this predefined email, like, mm-hmm, of marketing or something, and it was written like, we might be interested to purchase it, let's make contact and so on. And I was like, this might be a scam, but you know, we will see how it will be. You know, I will not send them anything before that I will receive some money.
Yeah.
And anyway, the money that I will receive will just cover the expenses that I did, and that's it. So we will see what will happen.
Mm-hmm. And what happened next?
Happened next that we had several meetings and we were discussing like about how much I would sell my app. And we were also discussing the methods for exchange our source code, yeah, our App Store Connect account in this case, because we couldn't do the transfer. So yeah, anyway, let's call it transfer.
Yeah.
And so we found a deal that was quite flexible because we wanted to do in your way, but then in the end we did it in my way. Yeah. So we found, you know, a middle point. We signed a contract, so it was a little bit more relaxed.
Yeah.
And so everything went actually fine. I was really surprised that we managed everything like in a week or so.
How does it feel to make an exit?
Well, it feels really great because depends on the amount of money that you receive. You can do like, you can achieve some of your small dreams. Like in my case,
okay,
I decided to buy an American muscle car. So, you know,
American what?
I was muscle car.
What is it?
It's a Ford Mustang, you know, that real American cars. I was really following my dream. I was having these dreams like, oh, I want to buy the type.
How
of
much
car.
It so cost?
Like, okay, no. Well, it costed around like $40,000.
Okay, nice.
But mm-hmm, yeah, not that bad.
Yeah.
So I was having like the dream of having a sport car. I'm young and so on. So okay, I was like, I have the money. I'm young. I don't need to care about anything else. So let's go for it.
Now, what you do with your spare time? What is your new hobby?
Well, I'm still keep coding and so I'm still keep developing other applications like fulfill some other market gaps.
What are your recommendations for you know, fellow developers that maybe has some nice app that is generating money and I don't know, they are working on it, but to be honest, it never grows. What you can say to these fellow developers?
For sure, I will just recommend to not move the emails into the bin if they look like spam emails until you will not give a chance to, you know, connect and talk with some real people. The thing is that most of the people to which I was saying like, you know, I have been contacted because my application like got popular and someone wants to buy it. They said like, pay attention, it's for sure a scam, yeah, you will see. And then when I sent the code, you know, they already sent you like some part of the money. You send the code and now they will disappear. They will not send you the other part of the money. And I would say like, okay, this is a risk, you know. If you will not risk, you will not have anything in life. Yeah. I mean, you will feel completely like, yeah, dead. So let's risk. We will see. It doesn't matter. I will create another application. We will see if it will be the same successful or whatever.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So people are always skeptical about new things. But in the end, you know, you need to risk a little bit.
Okay, it was really fun to talk with you, Pietro. And
thank you, you too.
I hope that we will keep working together and develop great apps. And if you develop something for yourself, you're always open to share it with us and to offer us. Or if you hear about friends that has good apps, we can work with them as well. And okay, so thank you for your time.
All right. Thank you too.
Ciao, in Italian they say ciao, no? Arrivederci. What do you say? Yeah. Ciao.
Arrivederci, maybe this way we will see
with
soon.
With your
right?
accent, it even sounds better. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Ciao. Bye-bye.